He hit me up seriously the day we were ordering the freaking awards, and he was like, dude, jump on a Zoom with me, verify this shit. I'm gonna be on stage. I told you last year I was gonna be on stage. I'm gonna be on stage. As you guys know, hitting six figures a year, it's not easy, right? Of course we have systems, of course we give you tools, of course you have the support system of your brothers and sisters, which is fucking amazing. Just like Dan told you, it's amazing that you guys have that and you guys are able to grow so much faster, but it's still a lot of work. It's still a lot of effort. It's still a lot of massive, imperfect action that you guys have to put in and day out. And so with that being said, I wanna start giving out these six-figure awards. These are people over the last 12 months, and no, these aren't the same people that got it last year. These are new people over the last 12 months that have hit six figures in sales this year. And the first person is Stephanie Hibbard. Come up.
Hey, Stephanie!
Stephanie! By the way, I know she's here, but I can't see, and sooner or later she's gonna get here. But I didn't check to make sure everybody's
Hi,
here.
Hi, Stephanie.
So get up here, girl. Come on.
Look at my she just came out of Miami. Stephanie Hibbard from Miami.
Not Miami. She's fucking around. Love you. Give her. All right. So Stephanie obviously did a good job, guys. It's not easy getting these things, right? As you guys know, I've even talked to, and I believe it was, what, Tyler Lordy? Tyler, me and Tyler talked. He almost hit this thing, and I make you guys verify these. And so he was, like, right there. And he was, like, trying so hard to make this happen. There's no doubt in my mind he'll be standing up here next year. But every person that you see coming up here on this stage, it's been verified. These people have worked their asses off to make this happen. So please give your warm welcome to Amy Batchelor.
We love Amy. We love Amy.
Amy, you're a boss. Dope. Super dope.
Amy actually is a boss. She has that boss mentality.
Stand over here. Here you go. I'm gonna start going faster because we don't have as much time.
Amy.
Yes. Oh, pitcher. Ready? Can I keep her?
Where are we at? I don't know where to look.
Amy Batchelor.
All right, thank you.
You actually do walk like a boss. Like,
yeah, you're a
she
boss.
Moves like a boss. Like, her name's Amy.
Hey, we need to go over here and take a picture in front of this.
Yep.
There you go.
Come on.
All right. Thank you, Dan, for the heads up.
Thank you.
Once again, hey, success leaves clues. My mentor's telling me to do something. I better shut the fuck up and just do it.
You guys heard that today.
Let's
success leaves clues.
All right, let's go. Rock, rock, rock. Anthony, Chris, let's go.
Oh, you know who you are,
hey,
Anthony. Come on down the ramp,
you know
Anthony.
You. Come on, bro. Anthony's amazing. Stay right there. We're going to get Anthony in the middle.
Anthony.
Love you, dude. Yeah, give me a hug. You know I'm a hugger. Photo. Photo op. Thank you. All right, next
Thank
up.
Thank you, Anthony.
Mr. Larry Powell.
Larry Powell. We all, you know, all the new guys in this group love Larry Powell.
You want to run it?
No. I'm all right, baby. Don't worry about me. I quit school because of recess. I don't play games.
Let's go. All right, brother.
Hi, Larry.
Absolutely. You deserve it.
There you go.
Take a photo.
Right here. Thank you. Thank you. All right, next up, you guys all know this guy who's standing on stage today. Mr. Devin Norton. Hey, hey, hey.
Do you want it with or without the tongue?
We got to back up on the, right here, in between. Ready? She said, baby, I am. right.
All right, next up.
Next up, Josiah Schmidt.
Woo! Mr. Schmidt in the building. Million Dollar Man. Come on, Josiah.
Hey, only guy in the whole room with a BAM hat. He deserves it.
Let's go, Josiah.
Bam.
Hey, Josiah!
Bam! All right, cool. Next up, oh, this guy's cool. So he came in grinding. I don't have time for storytelling, but he came in grinding. Kids out of Phoenix. I remember when he first started, I was like, dang, this guy's got something. And it was the action that he took. Like, he didn't know much, but the little bit he knew, the guy was just grinding it out, and that's Bryce Coleman.
Oh, Bryce.
Yeah. Grinding it.
He actually
came out to Phoenix. We were out there in Scottsdale.
Yeah,
we
during March of 2020.
Yeah, we rented a house out there, and he came out, and the guy was just like, I felt like he was like, he listened so intently. I felt like he was sucking my soul when I was talking. I was like, da-da-da-da, and he was just like, he was taking everything in. I felt like he was taking it in and writing it down at the same time, and this kid just blew up quick.
Yep.
Bryce.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
Bryce.
Over here. Come on in. There you go. Yep, Middleville. Alrighty. Thank you.
What's your type, Bryce?
All right, hey.
Oh.
You guys see this guy in the group all the time, grinding, growing, helping out, Mr. Paul Heck.
Woo! Woo! Paul Heck, where you at? You look really nice tonight.
Dang, what are you doing? What kind of cologne you wearing? Hey. Man, that was a good one. I like it. Paul's a giver, by the way. He's in there giving in the group like crazy. Huh?
Giver's game.
Yeah, he's going to be the next one. Yep. Next one, Jonathan Davis.
Hi, Jonathan.
Come on up. There he is. Bat, 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 bat. Do you want to hand this to him? I'll go that side. Ha, ha. This is my good side anyway. I don't know why she always takes my good side. Got it? Thank you. Jonathan, thank you. All right. This next guy, first off, he made six figures before he even came in here, but he quit that shit to come make six figures here. So Mr. Sean Kochel.
Mr. Sean Kochel.
He's probably so drunk he can't get up.
He might have put me in a headlock the other day. We don't know about that.
You got it? You got it? Hey.
Sean.
By the way, I talked to Hope. We're going to shave his mustache tomorrow at the event. So make sure you're here. Get in here. Hey, funny story, but...
No, Josh, don't do that shit.
Yeah, I'll be up here all day if she keeps letting me do this. All right, next one, Joel Schmidt. Come on
Joel
up.
Schmidt, coming in from Indianapolis. There we go, Joel Schmidt. Let's go.
Hey. All right, we're almost there.
We love you.
Woo! Yes, got you. That's your award.
Yes. We love the Schmidts.
All right. Oh. Hey.
Hey.
Hey. Hey. All right, this lady is super cool. I am going to tell a story. I don't care what my wife says. She can only hold me down so long. I'm coming out.
Well, I got your ass forever.
Right. I already know. All right, so this next person, super freaking awesome lady. Actually, you guys probably all heard this story. My wife got me drunk. You guys know she does that often. But she got me drunk, and she was actually with Tori.
No, they bought a dog. No, we did not buy any
dog. They
dogs.
Bought a dog middle of the night. I woke
dogs.
Up the next door
no, we didn't.
Next day, and I was like, what just happened? And they're
I
like,
said,
oh,
you got got.
We bought
you got
a dog.
Got.
And so, you know, this dog was out. Where was this dog at?
Jazzy.
Ohio.
We bought a
this
dog from Ohio.
This dog was all the way in Ohio, and I was like,
we didn't want our dog staying in Ohio for too
long. When should I get my
long?
Dog? COVID was happening.
So
a bunch
we outsourced.
Stuff was happening. And I'm like, once you're a part of the family, like, you got
to
come.
You got to get home, baby. You
got
to get home to mama.
Right? And so, like, I did whatever I could. I posted in the group. Actually, Tori was like, you got a big group. Post in the group. And I was like, yep, boom. Posted in the group. And this lady stood up tall for us. Her
really
and her
tall.
Husband.
Really tall.
Really tall. Drove 4.5 hours to go and pick up this puppy. At
Champ.
And
his name's
She didn't
Champ.
Even know this. She didn't even know this. But it was at an Amish house, and the lights were like pitch black, and it was like dirt roads, and she was there at 3 o'clock in the morning, and this guy comes out with a lantern.
Do you have the rest of my money?
Hey, hey, I don't know about you guys, but if that was me, I would have fucking tucked tail. Man, she stuck it out with her husband, picked the dog up, and flew it out to Las Vegas for me. Miss Kylie Rena.
Kylie! Woo!
Beast mode.
Come on, Kylie, get up here, girl. Come on. Shake it. Shake it like your mama made it.
Get over here, girl. Hey, Christian, you just ditched her. Okay, I get it. She's like, I'm on video. Here, take your word. Let's do it. You people are amazing.
I love you so much.
All right, this guy last year was really trying to make this the word. He actually came up to me at Bam Jam last year, and he was like, dude, I'm gonna be up on the fucking stage next year. I promise you, no matter what I do. And I checked in with him, checked his finances. I obviously asked for bank account, all kinds of stuff when I'm doing this, but checked it. And he was like $7,000 off like 2 months ago. And he just was like, dude, I'm gonna make this happen. And as you know, you can't just get awards overnight. You gotta order them like way in advance. And he hit me up seriously the day we were ordering the freaking awards. And he was like, dude, jump on a Zoom with me, verify this shit. I'm gonna be on stage. I told you last year I was gonna be on stage. I'm gonna be on stage. And I was like, okay, you're right. Hey, Zoom. I just like stopped everything I was doing, jumped on Mr. Nick McCallion. Get up here.
Hey Nick.
All right. Next up, you guys already seen him up here. He won Sales Accelerator, Alex Balestro.
$1 million smile. Come on up, $1 million smile. This guy should be nominated for a Colgate commercial.
What's going on right now? Is this like something you and Sean Colgate?
He's really cool. Really cool guy.
So, Sean has the porn mustache. He's got the porn hat. Together, they're brothers.
That's a scary combination.
There you go. Thank you. Yeah. All right.
Who's next, baby?
Can you read that? I can't. Yep.
Can I read
She's
that?
She's going to announce
Of course, yeah, I can read that.
Let's go.
Jeanette Misuraca.
Yep, give it back.
Jeanette, I know you, Jeanette. Get your butt up here.
Jeanette, get your ass
Jeanette,
up here.
Jeanette, get up here.
Jeanette,
get up here, Jeanette.
Misuraca.
You guys got to look at her shirt. It's
Jeanette,
Italian vintage.
Jeanette, get up here.
Jeanette, get up here. So Jeanette has the coolest shirt. Italian
And while you're
vintage.
Up here, pronounce your last name.
I know her last
name, I'm
going to
feel
Josh.
Like an idiot. I guarantee it. Misuraca.
That's my girl.
All right, get up here. All right.
Italian vintage.
Mizoraka! Jeanette!
Mizoraka!
There you go. All right. All right, next up, Mr. Greg Ross.
Greg Ross.
Let's go.
All right, thank you, Greg Ross. Who is it, babe?
I got it. All right, this next guy comes from another country, and like when you, and it's not Simon. I know Simon has the sexy Australian accent.
Yeah, Tori comes in, she goes, I love the Australian accent.
So this next guy comes from another country, and obviously, you know, being here in America, like, if you had an excuse to give up, it would be coming from another accent and people not understanding you, you'd give up, right? This guy has been in this course less than a year, but has been able to hit this six-figure award despite any obstacle that you or I might act like we had in our way. And that guy is Nassos Pappas.
We all love Nassos. Don't act like y'all don't love Nassos. Y'all love Nassos. He's from Greece. He's beautiful, and he sent me wonderful olive oil for my salad because apparently,
and he pulls it off.
Apparently, what's that oil we used to use?
I can't hear you. You're like background.
Yeah. We used to use bad oil, but he sent me really good olive oil for my salad.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Nassos.
Hey. I love you,
dude.
Thank you,
guys.
Yeah, you made it. Winning.
Thank you.
All right, ready?
He's a giver, by the way.